Hooping your fabric, your stabilizer, and any project you attempt to embroider does take a little practice. But let me show you a couple tricks that I use when teaching classes and getting newbies up to speed about the hooping of their fabric. First off, you always want to use two layers of stabilizer. You'll always see me do that through all my classes. So I've just taken some tearaway. This is some cotton fabric, so I want to use tearaway on the back of it. If you're using something that's stretchy, like a sweatshirt or a t-shirt, highly recommend the cutaway stabilizers. The other thing that's my best friend is 505 spray. This is going to help keep all the layers together when I'm hooping it, and also so I don't stretch the fabric accidentally while I'm getting it all in the hoop. So you will see that I'll always be spraying my stabilizers, not my fabric. So I'm going to just give my stabilizer a little spray. It's like post-it note in a can, so it's really going to just help hold it. Now normally I don't spray this close to a machine, but for today I'm going to just be really careful. I often recommend some type of like spraying area, then that way you any overspray is not going to get on your equipment. Now the nice thing about spraying the stabilizer and then laying the fabric on is that when I go to hoop this, you know how usually you can pull? See, I can't even stretch that fabric out. If I didn't have this attached, you'll notice that that fabric really stretches, but when it's attached to stabilizer, hence the name, you'll find that hooping this becomes a lot easier. So this hoop that I'm using is the 240 by 150 size. This came with your machine. And the first thing to do is go ahead and unclip the little quick release and then open this up so there's a little bit of extra room in here. You'll want to keep the inner hoop always with the writing or the numbers closest to you, and you'll be able to read the word Pfaff up here at the top. The next thing is, so that's the inner hoop that goes on top of your fabric. The other thing is that this bracket, this is the part that actually attaches to the embroidery machine. So I always set this down on the table first, keeping it on my left side, and this little quick release is always in the bottom right corner. So lay that down. Go ahead and get this in. If you have lines, you can use these little marks right here and here to help get that in nice and straight. Today, I'm not worrying about straightness. I'm just doing some test embroidery. Notice I'm putting the top edge in first, rolling this off the edge of the table, so to make sure that this little part will flip in. And if it's hard to push that in, loosen the screw a little further. Next, after you've got the two slightly pushed together, take the quick release and close it. Now, once again, if you can't push this closed, I can, so it's not hard right here. If you can't push it, open this screw. Do not force this. Eventually, this will break, I promise you, because we over tighten it and then we don't give it time to open up enough. So, but if you take the time to unscrew it, you will be able to nicely click it closed and then finish tightening it with the screw. Now, I know I said that will break, so when it happens, you're going to be using it. Remember, you've got two other hoops with this machine. You can transfer one of those clips over here. I know I've done that. So, and of course, just like always, you only break it when you are using it. Okay, so the last thing I like to do, and definitely make sure this screw goes as tight as your fingers can go. I usually don't recommend that you use any type of screwdriver or anything. Just go as tight as you can, and then take your fingers, I'm taking them on the inside of this little corner, push just a little past flush. So that means that this lower hoop is just barely has a little ridge all the way around, kind of sticking out past the inner hoop here, yep, or the outer hoop, depending on which way you're looking. It also makes it really quiet when you are set up. Now, right now, my embroidery arm is in the park position, so one thing you're not gonna do is put your hoop on until this is moved all the way over. The machine will guide you, and that's so you don't accidentally hit that foot. So for right now, I might just slide this underneath my foot and lay it on the bed of the machine until I'm ready to bring up my design and get everything hooped, everything attached and ready to embroider.